Join Charles and Hillary Price as they journey to South America, from the Amazon River in Peru, to the markets of Central Bolivia, to the high Andes Mountains of Ecuador. Find out how God is using Living Truth to bring the gospel to the ends of the earth.
When Luke recorded the words of Jesus, "You will be my witnesses to the ends of the earth," he could not have imagined the countries and peoples that we know today all across the globe. On this program, and for the following 2 weeks, we're going to visit some of the far corners of South America. If you look at a world map, the ends of the earth don't get much further away from Jerusalem than South America. Today, Living Truth is coming to you from Bolivia. We want to show you how Living Truth, translated into Spanish, is being used on radio and television to bring the gospel to what seems to us like the ends of the earth. My wife, Hillary, is with me on this journey, and she'll be bringing you some of their reports. She'll also be teaching university students and church leaders along the way. So stay with us for the next hour as we connect with real people who are engaged in Living Truth at the ends of the earth.
The ends of the earth, Living Truth in South America.
The story from Bolivia is about a couple who have overcome enormous obstacles to serve Christ. It's a story about a man who experienced such deep despair that he didn't want to live. It's about the woman who came alongside to join him in his struggle and who now faithfully keeps their mission going. If you've ever felt desolation so deep that you could see no way out, this story will engage and encourage you.
This is Nelson Choque's home. He lives here with his wife, Genoviva, and two daughters. His leg and most of his right hand is gone, the result of a train accident when he was younger. Every day is a struggle, but that horrible event is not the only challenge he's faced.
Nelson, can you tell me a little about your life before you became a Christian?
When I remember my childhood, I always cry because many times I walk in the street looking for food in the garbage to take home. And when I was 6 or 7 years old, I started running away from home. I was hungry, and I met many children in the street, and together we begged.
Nelson's father died, and in Bolivia, with no social safety net, the family spiraled down into poverty.
Many times in the street I used to scream, "Why don't I have a father? Why am I on the street? Why don't I go to school? Why am I not studying? Why do I have to live like this?"
Nelson worked at odd jobs, trying to find food, safety, and love.
The years passed by, I was 16 years old. I forgot my family. We didn't have a place to sleep. We worked during the day and sleep at night on the street. In my 16 or 15 year, I learned to drink.
It's no wonder that the lure of easy money through selling drugs was attractive to Nelson.
I said that I want to go to Chapare and see what kind of world it was. There started the era of coca, the era of cocaína.
Nelson had entered the dark world of cocaine trafficking. He worked for the drug lords until a train journey changed his life forever.
One day when I was traveling, I climbed on top of the train to take a little bit of fresh air. I remember that when I went back into the train, I felt like a hand was pushing me. I wanted to hold on something, but I couldn't. I only remember when I fell down, and then I don't remember anything else.
And did somebody come to help you? And
when people approached, they were afraid to come closer because all my guts were out and my leg was destroyed. And finally, one of them came closer and I told him, do me a favor, give me a knife so I can kill myself. When they took me to the hospital, I always wanted to die. I didn't want to live. I was full of hate against God. I said, God doesn't exist. There's no God. Because before, when I was an adulterer, I stole and I did so many things, nothing happened to me. There's no God.
Nelson had lost a leg and most of his right hand. With his remaining hand, he reached for the Bible left by the Gideon Society. He read, and if your right hand causes you to stumble, cut it off and throw it away. It is better for you to lose one part of your body than for your whole body to go into hell.
Then I started to cry and said to God, now I understand why. When the doctor said I was going to die, you always keep me alive. Now I understand why I am here. In that moment, I received the Lord by myself. I said, Lord, I invite you to come to my heart. I want to receive you. Now I understand why I am here.
You're watching To the Ends of the Earth, Living Truth in South America. Stay tuned to find out how God used the tragedies in Nelson Choquet's life for good.
From the moment Nelson became a Christian, he started to tell people about Jesus. One day, while giving his testimony over the radio, he recognized that media could be used to reach others for Christ.
And why do you feel it's so important for the gospel to be shared in this way?
Because we can reach those places where people are working, in their office. It is easier to get to them. That is why media is so important. And I believe that the Lord wants to use it to share the gospel.
Nelson bought a small transmitter and began a radio broadcast. Over the years, he's acquired bigger and better equipment.
This morning we want to give away CDs from the ministry Vive la Verdad, Experiencing Christ in You. If you call us, you are going to get this beautiful CD that we have to give away.
For 2 hours every day, Nelson hosts a live radio program in this tiny room that serves as his studio. The program has music and talk. It reaches the local community through the antenna in his backyard. He also began a TV station, which broadcasts via a makeshift satellite dish. Living Truth supports Nelson and Genoviva by sending the Viva La Verdad half-hour radio and TV programs in Spanish for Nelson to broadcast.
What is different is that the materials are made with love and passion for lost souls. It doesn't matter the language, it reaches the heart of the people, and that is what impacted me about Vive la Verdad.
So what impact do you feel the program is having?
The people always ask. They have told me that it is a good program, but that sometimes we were repeating it. They ask if there are any new episodes of the program Vive la Verdad.
Nelson has already broadcast all of the Spanish Living Truth episodes available. That's why Living Truth is producing more, to keep radio stations like Nelson's supplied with new material.
So you're reaching lots of people. Can you tell me a little bit about the funding of the station?
We finance ourselves with the work of my wife suing and me selling CDs everywhere I go. That is the only economic source we have to finance the radio and the TV station.
It's Genoviva's sewing business that keeps the family and the mission afloat.
Here, all the Christian brothers are new believers. They are not used to donating to the ministry. It's hard for them. But there are a few that give money, but sometimes it's not enough. That's why we have to look for a way to find a source of income. At night, I sew. When I had my two little ones, I started sewing at night because during the day, I didn't have time.
So we need to pray that you will get people alongside you who you can teach to take this from you. And you started with your daughter.
Yes, Carla is very interested in the things of the radio and TV. She has always been interested in the technical aspect to solve problems that we have, thanks to the Lord. We do have many difficulties, but we are going to remain working using media.
Carla started working in the radio station when she was 7. There's no money to hire help.
There have been moments that one has to face, especially financially. That is one difficulty in order to do many things for God's work. Without money, it's not possible. But with God's help, putting everything in His hands, we have been able to go forward. Yes.
There are always challenges. Just recently, an electrical storm burnt out most of the broadcasting equipment. The radio station is now back up and running, but the TV station is still out of action. Nelson needs a computer to get it back on the air.
All the equipment we have for the radio and TV all got burnt. That was really hard on us. I was asking the Lord why this happened. We are working for Him. We don't have economical resources to keep it up.
Nothing else really matters, although sometimes one cries. Sometimes I feel tired. But that is just for a moment. All of that I place in the Lord's hands. He gives me the strength to keep going. In the midst of this, I get to know the Lord more. I thank Him because I can always feel His presence.
Before the Living Truth team leaves Entre Rios, Spanish manager Carlos Lopez has a big surprise for Nelson.
Thanks to God and to the ministry Vive la Verdad. This is to bring the Word of God and for others to experience Christ in them today.
Nelson has overcome a tough childhood and a debilitating accident to become a servant of God, using the media to reach souls.
TV and radio have a massive role to play in this part of the world. The radio is a vital possession for every family. And television is rapidly becoming affordable and more available, often through small broadcasting stations in remote areas. Media is a vital means to bring the gospel to people who are often poor, illiterate, or isolated. Many of these smaller broadcaster stations have requested Viva La Verdad. Across Latin America, we are on the air on 100 radio stations and 60 television stations. In the main, it's the small, independently owned television and radio stations that have become our broadcasting partners. We want to support these local stations and the work that they do. So we pay a modest amount to them for airtime and also to support their ministry so these stations can continue to exist. We need funds to produce the Spanish version of Living Truth and also to support the radio and TV stations which broadcast them to the ends of the earth. May I challenge you to come alongside these forward-thinking media leaders so they can expand their reach to the people who most need to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Viva La Verdad, the Spanish version of Living Truth, began broadcasting in 2010 thanks to your financial and prayer support. The messages of Charles Price are translated and dubbed into Spanish using state-of-the-art technology.
Querías decirles cuando ellos me escucharon decir desde la cruz, Padre, perdónalos, ellos no saben lo que hacen. Y lo dijo específicamente acerca de esos soldados.
Come with us on this exciting journey. Participate through prayer and join us financially to bring the gospel to places like Entre Rios in Bolivia. Please send a check to Living Truth, P.O. Box 210, Chessington, KT990H, UK. Or call free phone 0800-197-3434 to donate with a credit card. On the internet, go to livingtruth.co.uk to make a secure donation. Your gift, large or small, is valued and helpful. Prayerfully consider support for Viva La Verdad. It is one of the most effective means of bringing the gospel to the ends of the earth.
Un saludo muy especial a todo el
Special
equipo.
Greeting to the whole team at Vive La Verdad. Keep going with the passion to reach souls. As your slogan says, experiencing Christ in you.
Experimentando a Cristo en su vida.
Evangelical University in Santa Cruz is the first private university in Bolivia and the first evangelical university in Spanish-speaking South America. The goal of this university is to reach the youth of Bolivia for Christ through higher education. Many of the students in the Faculty of Social Work are from low-income families. They're being trained to use Living Truth materials to take the gospel back to their communities. They have become Viva La Verdad ambassadors. Here is one of them, and her name is Carla.
Carla, a psychology student, is learning how to use books by Charles Price that are translated into Spanish. A study guide divides the book into bite-sized pieces.
I have a small group at home, so it will be very good to use this material so they can have its knowledge.
Students like Carla are trained by Carlos Lopez to use Living Truth materials to reach out to young people, especially in poor areas. When literacy is a problem, this audio device is used instead of a book. It contains the Bible in Spanish, plus 200 messages from Charles.
I love the idea of the audio Bible. It's excellent. I'm going to use it after I learn how to work with it. That excites me because I'm going to have more implements, more tools, so I can talk with others about the gospel and discipleship.
What are you seeing God is leading you to beyond this university, beyond your time here?
La verdad que elegí mi carrera de psicología.
I chose my career to be a psychology, to be able to help others through the science of psychology, but as well to live with them the principles and teaching. In that moment, I will be talking with them and telling them that the Lord is the one who can help them, not only me. He is the only one who can take them out from any trouble.
Él es el único que puede sacarte de cualquier problema.
Carla is fortunate to attend this university on a scholarship. She comes from a poor family who would otherwise not be able to afford the tuition fee.
You chose to come to this university. Why this university particularly?
For me, it was always a dream to come to this university because it is Christian and evangelical. I believe it is my second home. I love to be here. The environment, everything is beautiful, and it is overall a Christian environment. To be surrounded by people who think the same as I do.
The campus is a calm refuge from the stormy world that confronts youth in Bolivia. Drug wars, endemic corruption, unemployment, and poverty are real challenges. These students are coming to a Living Truth-sponsored conference to learn how to tackle these issues. It's called TEL, Training and Equipping Latin American Leaders. Everyone here receives books, study guides, DVDs, CDs, and an audio player in a gift package from Living Truth. They learn how to effectively use them to evangelize in small study groups.
Listening to you, it sounds as though evangelism, sharing Jesus, is very much a part of your life. Would that be true?
Yes, I have a small group at home. It is a small cell group where every Tuesday night I share the scriptures with them. We always try to bring new people so they can know the gospel.
University students like Carla are the future leaders of Bolivia. Now they have Viva La Verdad resources and training to equip them to reach out to young people in their communities. Living Truth wants to provide these resources to more Christian leaders in South and Central America.
We've just heard the story of Carla, a young social work student at the Evangelical University of Bolivia. I was delighted to be asked to give a talk to the students at this university, and my message today is centered on loneliness apart from God. I've called it playing hide and seek with God.
Loneliness is something all of us know something about.
La soledad es algo en lo que todos nosotros podemos pensar.
I think one of my loneliest times was when I was first a student at university.
Uno de los tiempos de más soledad que yo pude experimentar fue durante mis años de universidad.
And maybe when you first came to this university, you felt very lonely because you didn't know many people.
Y estoy segura que cuando ustedes llegaron a esta universidad, se sintieron muy solos porque no conocían a mucha gente.
So we're going to talk about loneliness this afternoon.
Así que voy a hablar un poco acerca de esa soledad en esta tarde.
If you were a child like me when you were little, you liked to play the game of hide and seek.
Cuando ustedes eran pequeños así como yo, seguramente les gustaba jugar a las escondidas.
Where all the children run away and find somewhere to hide and then somebody comes to find them.
Donde los niños están todos reunidos, se cuentan los números y todo el mundo sale corriendo para esconderse.
If you find a very good hiding place, you think you're very clever because nobody finds you.
Y claro, cuando tú encuentras un lugar muy bueno para esconderte, te sientes muy inteligente, nadie me va a encontrar aquí.
But after a while, you start to feel lonely, because instead of wanting to hide anymore, you want somebody to find you.
Pero después de un momento en que nadie te está encontrando por ese buen lugar, de repente te sientes solo y quieres que alguien te encuentre.
And there are lots of ways we hide, and we just wish somebody could see us and find us.
Y hay muchas ocasiones en donde uno está escondido y de alguna forma estamos buscando que alguien nos encuentre.
There's a person in the Bible like that, and his name is Zacchaeus.
Y encontramos en la Biblia a un personaje llamado Zaqueo.
And he represents every man and every woman who longs for more but has settled for less.
Y esa es la historia de cada hombre o mujer que se ha de alguna forma se ha adecuado para esperar lo mínimo.
The story we are going to read is found in Luke chapter 19. So if you have your Bible, you can open it and you can follow along, and Fanny will read Luke chapter 19, verses 1 to 10. Jesus entered Jericho and was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being a short man, he could not because of the crowd. So he ran ahead and he climbed a sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down immediately. I must stay at your house today." So he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, "He has gone to be the guest of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood up and said to the Lord, "Look, Lord, here and now I give half of my possessions to the poor, and if I've cheated anybody out of anything, I'll pay back four times the amount." Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost." The best way to understand a Bible story is to look for a theme.
La mejor forma de estudiar un pasaje de la Biblia es buscar un tema.
The best way to look for a theme is to look for a word that is repeated.
La mejor forma de encontrar el tema es buscar una palabra que se repita una y otra vez.
So this passage is all about seeing.
Este pasaje tiene que ver todo con el ver.
This is the story of a man.
Es la historia de un hombre.
Verse 3, who wanted to see Jesus.
Un hombre que quería ver a Jesús.
Verse 3, he could not see over the crowd.
En el verso 3 dice que él estaba tratando de ver, pero la multitud se lo impedía.
Verse 4, he ran ahead to see Jesus.
Verso 4 dice que él corrió para ver a Jesús.
Verse 5, Jesus stopped and looked up at him.
En el verso 5, Jesús miró hacia arriba y le dijo.
Verse 6, all the people saw and they muttered.
El verso 7, todos empezaron a murmurar.
And verse 8, Zacchaeus stood up and he said, "Look, Lord."
Y en el verso 8 dice que Zaqueo dijo, "Mira, Señor."
So there are six times in this passage that the Bible talks about seeing.
Aquí tenemos en este pasaje seis veces donde se menciona el ver.
So what does it say to us about seeing?
Entonces, ¿qué nos dice esto a nosotros en cuanto al ver?
It shows us the journey of a man who wanted to see Jesus, but did not want Jesus to see him.
Podemos ver que esta es la historia de un hombre que quería ver a Jesús.
That's at the beginning of the story.
Pero él no quería que Jesús lo vea al inicio de la historia.
But at the end of the story, he wants Jesus to see him.
Pero al final de la historia, él quiere que Jesús lo vea.
I wonder which part of that man you are.
Me pregunto ahora qué parte de la historia de este hombre es tu historia.
Whether you want to see Jesus, but you don't want Jesus to see you.
Tú quieres ver a Jesús, pero tú no quieres que Él te vea a ti.
Or you want Jesus to see you.
O quieres que Jesús te vea.
What brings about the change in Zacchaeus' life?
¿Qué trajo el cambio en la vida de Zaqueo?
Zacchaeus' name, verse 2, there was a man called Zacchaeus, means pure and clean and just.
En el verso 2 vemos que hay un hombre llamado Zaqueo, y el significado de su nombre era puro, limpio y justo.
So when his mommy and daddy named him, they picked the name Zacchaeus out of the baby book. They wanted their child to be pure and clean and just.
Así que los papás de Zaqueo, cuando tuvieron a su hijo, eligieron un nombre porque querían que su hijo fuese puro, limpio y justo.
They had wonderful plans for their son.
Esos fueron los planes maravillosos que los padres tenían para su hijo.
But maybe they had not planned what Zeus would become, a tax collector.
Pero ellos no se esperaban lo que pasó con Zaqueo. Se convirtió en un recaudador de impuestos.
And when you read the Bible, tax collectors are always put with sinners. Sinners and tax collectors.
Cuando uno lee la Biblia, uno se da cuenta que relacionan a los pecadores con los recaudadores de impuestos o recaudadores de impuestos y pecadores.
So now this little baby boy called pure, clean and just has become a man who is a tax collector.
Así que este lindo niño que se supone que debía ser puro, limpio y justo, ahora se convirtió en un recaudador de impuestos.
And tax collectors collected taxes for the Romans, and they were despised.
Y los recaudadores de impuestos colectaban los impuestos para los romanos. Por eso eran despreciados.
The money was tainted. It was dirty money.
Era dinero sucio.
So they couldn't go into the temple. They couldn't offer their money in worship.
Ellos no podían ir al templo, no podían entregar ese dinero allá ni compartirlo.
So the tax collector has lots of money, but no friends to spend the money on.
Así que Zaqueo tenía bastante dinero que había recolectado, pero no tenía con quién compartir ese dinero.
When Jesus stops under Zacchaeus's tree, he does not see a tax collector.
Cuando Jesús vio a ese árbol, él no vio a un recaudador de impuestos.
He sees a sad, lonely little man hiding behind a leaf.
Él vio a un hombre solo, pequeñito, tratando de esconderse detrás de una hoja en un árbol.
And the lonely man wanted to see Jesus.
Y este hombre solitario quería ver a Jesús.
Zacchaeus finds himself in the crowd.
Zaqueo estaba en medio de una multitud.
And because he is so little, he can't see over the crowd.
Y como él era pequeñito, no podía ver entre la gente.
There might be a part inside you that feels very little.
Puede que tengas alguna parte en ti que se vea pequeñita.
Might be a place in you where you got hurt when you were a child, and that little place has never grown.
Puede ser que hay un lugar en tu vida que cuando fuiste pequeño fuiste herido y por eso esa pequeña parte nunca logró crecer y se quedó pequeña.
Maybe you love somebody and they hurt you.
Tal vez amaste a alguien y esa persona te hirió.
So now you find it difficult to love.
Y ahora encuentras que es difícil volver a amar.
Maybe you trusted somebody and they walked away from you.
Tal vez confiaste en alguien y esa persona te dio las espaldas.
So now you find it very difficult to trust.
Ahora para ti es difícil volver a confiar.
You can never love until you let God love you.
No puedes amar si es que no permites conocer el amor de Dios en tu vida.
And when we're hurting and when we're lonely, it's very easy to hide in the crowd.
Cuando uno es solitario y pequeñito, es fácil esconderse entre la multitud.
Sometimes we hide in a crowd of being busy.
Y a veces nos escondemos en una multitud con el estar ocupados.
We fill our lives with activity.
Llenamos nuestras vidas con actividades.
So we never have to stop and think, and we never have to stop and feel how lonely we really are.
Así que no tenemos ningún segundo para hacer una pausa y darnos cuenta cuán solos estamos, cuán necesitados estamos.
Zacchaeus has been very busy making money.
Zaqueo estuvo ocupado haciendo dinero.
But he hears Jesus is coming.
Pero él sabía que Jesús estaba viniendo.
And he's not satisfied.
Aún así, él no estuvo satisfecho cuando lo supo.
So he's determined to see Jesus.
Así que fue determinado para ver a Jesús.
So Zacchaeus climbs the tree so he can see Jesus, but Jesus can't see him.
Así que Zaqueo se subió al árbol para ver a Jesús, aunque Jesús no lo veía.
We were made by God to know God.
Nosotros fuimos creados para conocer a Dios.
Zacchaeus doesn't know Jesus.
Zaqueo no conoció a Jesús, no conocía a Jesús.
But he knows he needs to know Jesus.
Pero él sabía que él quería conocer a Jesús.
And it is his loneliness that has led him to realize he needs Jesus.
Su soledad le hizo dar cuenta que él necesitaba a Jesús.
We don't need to fight our loneliness.
No necesitamos pelear en contra de nuestra soledad.
We don't need to try and overcome our loneliness.
No tenemos que tratar de solucionar nuestra soledad por nosotros mismos.
We need to learn to live our loneliness.
Tenemos que aprender a vivir nuestra soledad.
Because loneliness is the road that leads to intimacy with God.
Porque la soledad es el camino que nos lleva a una intimidad con Jesús.
It is through loneliness that you make your way and God makes his way to you.
El camino de la soledad es la que nos lleva a tener ese encuentro y todo tenga sentido con Jesús.
So the moment arrives in verse 5. Zacchaeus is hiding under the tree, up the tree, and Jesus comes and stands under the tree and looks up at him.
Así que llegamos al verso 5, donde él estaba trepado en el árbol y Jesús viene, se pone debajo del árbol y lo mira.
And as he looks up, he says his name, Zacchaeus.
Y en ese caso, él se paró, mira hacia arriba y dice su nombre, Zaqueo.
How does he know his name?
¿Cómo sabía el nombre de él?
Because he knows his name.
Porque él sabe su nombre.
And he knows your name.
Y él sabe tu nombre.
He knows every hair on your head.
Él sabe el número de tu cabello.
He knows you because he made you.
Él sabe porque él te creó.
And when you run away from God,
cuando corres lejos de Dios,
he follows right behind you.
Él te sigue por detrás.
So the day comes, you turn around.
Así que va a llegar el día en el que te vas a dar la vuelta.
And he's right there.
Y él está ahí, en tu cara.
Because he knows you.
Porque te conoce.
And suddenly, for Zacchaeus, he's right there.
Y para Zaqueo, estuvo ahí en su cara.
And he says a wonderful thing to Zacchaeus.
Y él le dice algo maravilloso a Zaqueo.
Come down immediately.
Y él le dice, baja enseguida.
I must stay at your house today.
Tengo que quedarme hoy en tu casa.
To know Jesus, you have to come down.
Para conocer a Jesús, tienes que bajarte.
He came down from heaven, down, 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 down.
Él bajó del cielo, abajo, abajo, abajo en la tierra.
To find you.
Para buscarte, para encontrarte.
You have to humble yourself and come down from your tree.
Tienes que humillarte, ser humilde y bajarte de tu árbol.
And we read in verse 6, so he came down at once.
Y en el verso 6 dice, así que se apresuró a bajar.
It's such a tiny word, so.
Aquí son dos palabras pequeñas, así que.
But it's the bridge to the next step.
Y ese es el puente para el siguiente paso.
If so he came down had never happened.
Si es que no hubieran habido esas dos palabras, el así que, significa que no pasó.
Jesus would not have come into his life and into his home.
Jesús no hubiera entrado a su vida ni a su casa.
If he had sat in the tree and said no.
Si Zaqueo hubiera dicho no.
Jesus would not have dragged him down from the tree.
Jesús no lo hubiera arrancado del árbol.
There comes a point when Jesus says, come to me.
Ahí el punto donde Jesús dice, ven a mí.
And then there is an invitation, now you come to me.
Él ha estado avanzando, avanzando, llegó ahí la invitación y es el tiempo en el que tú tienes que llegar a él.
If Zacchaeus had never come down from the tree,
si Zacchaeo no hubiera bajado del árbol,
Jesus would never have come to his house.
Jesús nunca hubiera llegado a su casa.
And Zacchaeus did not invite Jesus into his house.
Y Zaqueo no invitó a Jesús a su casa.
Jesus invited himself.
Jesús se invitó a sí mismo.
He said, I'm coming to your house to stay.
Él dijo, ahora voy a tu casa.
I must stay.
Y me voy a quedar.
When Jesus comes into your house, which is your body, your personhood, your being, you.
Cuando Jesús viene a tu corazón, a tu cuerpo, a todo lo que tú eres.
He doesn't come to have a cup of tea and then go away again.
No viene para tomar un cafecito y luego irse.
He comes to stay.
Él viene para quedarse.
He promises, abide in me, I will abide in you.
Él promete, si ustedes habitan en mí, yo habitaré en ustedes.
Verse 7 tells us, all the people saw and began to mutter, 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 mutter.
Y luego en el verso 7 nos dice que todos al ver esto, todos empezaron a murmurar y murmurar y murmurar y murmurar.
Ah. When you get close to Jesus, people will feel free to have an opinion about it.
Cuando uno se acerca a Jesús, la gente Se toma la libertad de estar murmurando.
Maybe some people in your family don't understand why you are at a Christian university.
Tal vez algunos miembros de tu familia no entienden por qué estás en una universidad cristiana.
Maybe you have friends who think you are loco.
Tal vez tienes algunos amigos que piensan que estás medio loquito.
So they matter about you.
Así que murmuran sobre eso.
But Jesus is your protector.
Pero Jesús es tu protector.
All the things that people throw at you, you are behind Jesus and he is protecting you.
Así que todas las cosas que las personas están lanzando en contra tuya no te llegan porque tú estás detrás y Jesús es quien las recibe.
So now he protects Zacchaeus.
Él lo protege. Él es una persona que está protegida por él.
And he ignores all the nosy people peeping in through the window.
Y él también conoce a las personas que están ahí tratando de ver por la ventana lo que está pasando.
Because something very exciting is happening in Zacchaeus's house.
Porque algo interesante está pasando en la casa de Zaqueo.
Instead of Zacchaeus hiding away from Jesus, not wanting Jesus to see him,
porque ahora Zaqueo está quiere ver a Jesús. Él ya lo ha visto.
Zacchaeus wants Jesus to see him.
Ahora él quiere que Jesús lo vea.
He stands up and he says, "Look, Lord."
Ahora él se para y dice, "Mira, Señor."
Have you ever stood in front of God and said, "Look at me"?
¿Alguna vez te has parado y dicho al Señor?
Have you ever said, "See me"?
¿Le has dicho al Señor, "Señor, mírame"?
See me with all my mess.
Mírame con todos los problemas que tengo.
And all my tax collecting.
En el caso de Zaqueo, mira todos los impuestos que agarré.
And all my life.
En toda mi vida.
And all my past.
Todo mi pasado.
See me.
Mírame.
Jesus came to live with us so he could live within us.
Jesús no vino a vivir con nosotros. Él vino a vivir en nosotros.
And what does Jesus want to give us?
Y eso es lo que él nos quiere dar.
He wants to give us himself.
Él nos quiere dar a sí mismo.
By his Holy Spirit.
Por su Espíritu Santo.
Come to live inside to stay.
Para venir a vivir y quedarse en nosotros.
Jesus is about to say to Zacchaeus and all the people listening, the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost.
Y lo que Jesús estaba por decir a todos ahí en la casa de Zaqueo fue, él vino a encontrar lo que se había perdido.
And they're all pointing at Zacchaeus, you are the lost.
Y ahora estaba apuntando a Zaqueo. A Zaqueo, tú estabas perdido.
I think Jesus says, the Son of Man came to seek and to save, and he turns around to the crowd, the lost.
Y cuando viene, él dice, yo vine a buscar lo que estaba perdido, ustedes.
All you people looking in through the window and judging and criticizing, you are the lost.
Todas las personas que están viendo por la ventana y murmurando, ustedes son los perdidos.
Because today salvation has come to this house.
Porque hoy la salvación llegó a esta casa.
Because this man invited me in.
Porque este hombre me invitó ahí a venir a él.
This is the whole of the gospel. In one little story, in a nutshell.
Este es el mensaje de todo el evangelio en una pastilla.
If you ever want to explain to someone how much God loves them, show them this story.
Si alguna vez ustedes quieren mostrar a alguien cuánto Jesús nos ama, muéstrenle esta historia.
And we're going to finish, but I need to say to you there are many trees that people hide in.
Y para terminar, solo quiero decirte que hay muchos árboles en los que muchos nos escondemos.
I want you to close your eyes.
Quisiera que por favor cierres tus ojos.
And this is a prayer.
Y esta es una oración.
And I'm going to name these trees. If one of these trees is your tree, and you want to come out of this tree because you know Jesus is calling you out of this tree, then you can. In the quietness of your heart, respond to Jesus. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you that you loved us so much you sent Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, that you didn't give up on us. Thank you that you came to find us hiding in our trees. And now you see me in my tree of shame, my tree of blame, my tree of pride, my tree of anger, my tree of bitterness, my tree of self-pity, my tree of criticism, my tree of self-loathing, my tree of insecurity, my tree of resentment, my tree of self-righteousness, my tree of laziness, my tree of unforgiveness, my tree of loneliness, my tree of self-sufficiency. Thank you that you say, come down. I must come to your house to stay. And thank you that because you promised, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you, that we will never be alone again, and we never need be lonely again. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for loving us so much. And we pray in Jesus' name, amen. The students at the Evangelical University of Bolivia are using Living Truth materials to reach poor communities in Santa Cruz and even further afield. There are many requests for these kind of resources in Bolivia to bring the gospel to people who might otherwise not have access to balanced Bible teaching. Pastor and lay leadership training is another desperate need. Only a tiny fraction of pastors have formal theological training. Living Truth has an important role to play here as well.
Vamos a apreciarlo mucho.
We've launched a training program called TEL, Train and Equip Latin American Leaders. This program not only teaches pastors and leaders about basic Bible truths, it also trains them to use Living Truth materials in their communities. Together, these strategies make up the Living Truth mission in South America, and we hope you will come with us on this exciting journey to the ends of the earth.
Desde the People's Church in Toronto, Canada,
through the media, we are doing what was told to the apostles in Acts 1:8. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Please send a check to Living Truth, P.O. Box 210, Chessington, KT990H, UK. Or call free phone 0800-197-3434 to donate with a credit card. On the internet, go to livingtruth.co.uk to make a secure donation. Your gift, large or small, is valued and helpful. Prayerfully consider support for Viva la Verdad. It is one of the most effective means of bringing the gospel to the ends of the earth. You are watching a special edition of Living Truth, shot on location in Bolivia.
Truth in Spanish is not only seen in Central and South America, it has a wide audience among Spanish-speaking people in North America too. There's an estimated 50 million Spanish-speaking people in the United States and almost 1 million in Canada. Graciela and Uriel Sanchez are joint pastors of a Spanish church in Toronto. Living Truth DVDs and books are welcome resources they use for their congregation.
It's early morning, and Graciela is hard at work preparing for a Bible study she will lead tonight. The study is based on the book by Charles Price, Alive in Christ. Her husband, Uriel, watches a DVD from the Living Truth series, Journey into the Heart of God. He will use the DVD and guide to lead another study group. This is their mission field, Scarborough, Ontario. They arrived here 7 years ago from Colombia, but the call from God started much earlier.
Approximately 20 years ago, I received a special call from the Lord to come to Canada. During all this time, we have been always praying and asking for Canada, and we know that we are here with a special purpose that the Lord has given us.
Canada, God's heart is upon Canada. And it's important that if Canada is in God's heart, it is in mine as well.
Graciela and Uriel didn't know why God was calling them to pray for Canada. But when they were able to immigrate in 2008, it all became clear. They were missionaries.
My dream, my longing, and desire is to establish churches for God's glory to come down upon them.
Graciela earns money as a part-time house cleaner. Her real passion is her volunteer work as a church planter and pastor. Uriel works as a maintenance man in addition to his work as a pastor.
Because we arrived in Toronto, Canada as immigrant, one of the first things the Lord put us to do was to work with other immigrants from all over the world that has arrived here. But we focus on the Hispanic community.
The couple began with Spanish Bible study groups, but they ran into a problem. They didn't have relevant Bible study materials in Spanish.
To start the ministry and work with the Hispanic people, there was a big need for discipleship. It was very important that we didn't have any material specifically in Spanish.
That's when Graciela and Uriel found Viva la Verdad, Living Truth in Spanish. They found books, study guides, DVDs, and CDs.
It has made us see truth and fundamentals we haven't seen with that perspective. Even on a pastoral level, it has been a great blessing in our marriage, as ministers, as teachers in the church.
Their work flourished, and soon they were able to plant their own church. Today, the Spanish Community Alliance Church in Scarborough has a growing and enthusiastic congregation who have come to Canada from many parts of the world. Elso and Sandra are from El Salvador.
We were here as refugees at the Hotel Roycroft close by. Then we noticed that there was a food bank here. So I came for that, and I met Pastor Uriel Sanchez. He invited us to come to the church on Sunday. That is how we came here.
Loida Lopez came to Canada 11 years ago from Colombia.
The benefit of attending a Hispanic church is to interact with your own community. You are able to express your feelings in the same way, and you can express and have communion with God in your own language.
Every second week, the entire church breaks into smaller groups to study from the Viva la Verdad materials. For some, it has been life-changing.
Their testimonies of serving in church and their dedication to the Lord has shown us that the Lord's hand is behind all this, because He's making them grow and be transformed into the Christians He wants them to be.
These books from Vive la Verdad have explained events from the Bible and facts from the Bible in a way that it's different, making us think and reflect regarding God's truth in a different way.
That book taught me that Christ is waiting for us in that secret place, where every day we have to go to give thanks to God for His daily blessings. And I would like other people to feel the same. There are no words for what you feel in your heart. Nobody can explain it. That touched me deeply.
And it happened after the teaching of this book that she became a Christian. She got baptized, and that is why, by the will of God, she is what she is now.
Pastors Graciela and Uriel have seen remarkable changes in the entire church. God is working through the Viva la Verdad materials to bring people closer to Himself.
Help Living Truth bring the gospel to the ends of the earth. Please send a check to Living Truth, P.O. Box 210, Chessington, KT990H, UK. Or call free phone 0800-197-3434 to donate with a credit card.
On the internet, go to livingtruth.co.uk to make a secure donation. Your gift, large or small, is valued and helpful. Prayerfully consider support for Viva la Verdad. It is one of the most effective means of bringing the gospel to the ends of the earth.
Y este material vive la verdad.
This material, Vive la Verdad, I thank the Lord for the pastor's wisdom and the people who are working on it. I give thanks to the Lord because we benefit a lot as a church and as a congregation.
We trust in the Lord that soon this material will be taken to different churches and ministries. As our church has benefited, other new believers will be blessed as well.
Today, we've seen how radio and television can bring the gospel to isolated and poor communities in Bolivia, and how Viva la Verdad is in much demand by local television and radio stations for that purpose. We've heard about the need for training for pastors and church leaders in the fundamentals of Christianity. The Living Truth program called TEL, Training and Equipping Latin American Leaders, is helping to meet that need. Living Truth is going to the ends of the earth to be a witness to the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I trust that many of you will journey with us and support us both financially and in prayer. Next week, we travel to Peru. I look forward to bringing you more stories that will inspire, encourage, and challenge you. God bless you, and goodbye from Hillary and myself. Until next week.